On Bishop Barra's YouTube channel, you will find exclusive content to uplift your faith. The Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo. Live meetings from Bishop Barra Fonseca. Testimonies, thoughtful advice, prayers, and much more. Do you like it? Then subscribe today and share the videos on your social network. You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
My dear listeners, you who believe, be blessed, all of you, because you believe, because you have faith. It is faith in action, and is the Word of God obeyed. And this faith may not bring a result, immediate result. And it does not mean that it's not working. It can bring an immediate result. There are people who are healed, and they have been healed in the moment. And these people, they had faith and manifest their faith to receive it right now and then. But there are times that we need to wait for the right moment so that the faith can be fulfilled according to God's word. So we have the faith that surpasses the emotions, the faith that depends on motives, and because the faith that we believe is an intelligent faith that weighs, that thinks. For example, God created the heavens and the earth in 6 days. But how come He did not create in one day, or maybe in 1 hour? But He waited 1 day to create one thing and then create something else, and He gave time to time. So the faith that thinks gives time for the things that we may say, the things that take longer to happen, for it to take place, and may it all be in God's plan. So whoever believes, they are not in a hurry. Who believes does not run away. Who believes is not anxious. And whoever believes, they wait and they receive. And this is the faith that perseveres. But how come some people do not see the power of this faith? How come this faith is not revealed? Because there are many people who are religious, people who are even good, but they are people who do no harm to no one. But how come faith doesn't work for them? Because these people, in most of the times, they do not like the truth. They prefer lies, they prefer deceit. For example, a salesman, a car salesman, he speaks or he does whatever it takes in order to sell the car. So he tells the client a bunch of things just to sell the car. So any kind of salesperson, if they have to use lies in order to sell the product, this person, they do not want to let go of lies, because the lies is bringing profits. But of course, this profit will not last forever, and they're going to lose in some point. So it is important for you to understand that when people, they like lies, they tend to lie, even though they may live in lies, there are people that they live in lies, but they do not know that they are living in lies. So So when such people actually discover the truth, they completely let go of lies and turn to the truth. And Jesus says, He told His disciples like this. He told His disciples in this manner. This is what He says. The Spirit of truth, which is the Holy Spirit, whom the world cannot receive. Why can't the world receive the Spirit of truth? Because the world loves lies. The world we live in is a world of deceit, emotion. It's a world of party. So this world of addictions, this world of sins, this world of darkness, perverted. You see, for instance, we had two major disasters there in Mozambique. More than thousands of people died because of the hurricane that passed by. Not one rich person of this world, they made actions. Nobody. No one is caring. But when, for example, that cathedral over there, that cathedral, Notre Dame, the Notre Dame Cathedral, when that cathedral caught on fire, what happened? That cathedral, that does nothing to nobody. It helps nobody. It's just a cathedral that people visit. They go there to look at the place. Everything is just art. And then they go home and nothing. Nothing happens. It only gives them pleasure to say, I went to Paris. I went to the Notre Dame Cathedral and I saw this and I saw that. That's all. That's all these people receive. Nothing else. So when that church caught on fire, immediately various rich people, they sent billions of dollars. Billions of dollars were sent in order to recover that cathedral. While on the other hand, more than a thousand people died because of the hurricane in these two hurricanes that passed by, and not a single person did nothing. Why? Because they prefer art than people's lives. That's the reality. So we live in a world of lies, betrayal, deceit, evil, dark, unfair and unjust. Unjust. So this world, can they receive the Spirit of truth? No. Whoever wants the Holy Spirit, whoever wants the Spirit of God, they have to abandon this world. They have to die to this world. Otherwise, you are going to continue living in lies and being a partner of this world of lies. So Jesus says, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees Him or knows Him. And then Jesus, appointing to His disciples, His followers, He says, but you know Him. And they did know Him because they saw God's power. They saw Jesus doing miracles. So they knew Him. They knew the Spirit of God in the Lord Jesus that delivered people. And He says, for He dwells with you. So He dwells with you. It doesn't mean that the Spirit was inside of them. No. The miracles were done because He was there. But He says, and will be in you. So when Jesus died and resurrected, it was then that the Holy Spirit came to dwell inside of us. Well, you want the Holy Spirit? You are desiring the Holy Spirit. In fact, on the 19th, we are going to begin the fast of Daniel. The fast of sacrifice. The fast in which we are going to sacrifice internet, news, things of this world. We are going to sacrifice the things that are entertaining of this world. We are going to sacrifice what the world has to offer. And we're going to be restricted. We're going to restrict our mind, our understanding, only to the Word of God, thinking about God's will, thinking about only the things of God. And whoever wants the Spirit of truth, Whoever wants the Holy Spirit or the Spirit of Truth, or you want God's Spirit within you, so then you must make this sacrifice. You must place your all on the altar. You must give up lies, deceit. You must let go of sins. You must let go of the addictions. You must let go of this evil life that this world is offering. For example, maybe you that have been living in lies, and you know that you are living in lies, and you want the Spirit of Truth, you must give it up. Otherwise, you are going to continue in the church without partaking of the Spirit of Truth, without having the privilege of being the richest person in the face of the earth. Because whoever has the Spirit of God has happiness, has joy within them. And Jesus offers the Holy Spirit that eliminates, that removes depression, anxiety, and makes a person to be happy, satisfied, and joyful. And it doesn't matter if one has more or less. If they have more, they are happy. If they have less, they are happy. Because what brings joy to them, whoever brings joy to them, is the Spirit of Truth, is the holiness in God, is the counselor, is the comforter, is the one that gives strength, power, and opens vision, opens one's vision so that you can make your business, so that you can make money, so that you can have life, and you have the best of the land. My dear listener, the Spirit of God has been offered by the Lord Jesus Himself. In fact, it is promised by the Lord Jesus Christ, who resurrected. Jesus resurrected because of the Holy Spirit that has risen in Him. So imagine you receiving this Spirit, the Spirit of resurrection, the Spirit of faith, the Spirit of salvation, the Spirit of assurance. So this is very rich. This has no price, and there is no gold, no silver, and nothing that can compare to the greatness of God's power within you. I don't change this Spirit for nothing in this world. Nothing in this world, no family, money, success. I do not give it up. I praise my God, for He has given me His Holy Spirit. Although we have faced many battles, many disappointments, we have faced hatred, rejections from people, we have faced even persecution, facing hell itself, Satan himself and all his demons, I am still in faith. I am still here, and I will remain for eternity. And thanks be to the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of resurrection that lives in me. And that's why I'm still here. I am here actually trying to open your understanding, trying to make you understand that there is no other option. There is no better option out there. There is no better choice to do or to make. The best thing that ever happened in my life was to receive the Holy Spirit. And this happened 54 years ago. 54 years ago. 54 years ago. And this is wonderful. And I tell you, thanks be to God. Although, despite of all the things we faced, tribulation, pains, and cries, and injustice, and everything I faced, He has preserved me till this day. And I'm happy. And I thank Him. I can tell you that He is the same. What He did to me, He wants to do with you. I see it like this. Now pay attention. Think with me. When the Lord Jesus, He pours down His Spirit upon someone, immediately that person becomes happy. And then He seeks someone else to give His Spirit. So He is searching people so that He can pour His Spirit. But He can only find these people when these people, they are showing love for the truth, the desire to truly let go of deceit and to come to Him. I remember testimony of a woman. She was a call girl, and she once told us, I would, you know, give my life to only those that had money. But while I was there, in the moment of apparently of pleasure with my body, my thought was, oh my God, have mercy on me. I don't like this. I don't want to remain this life. I don't see no other option for life. I can't come out of this. But show me a way. So, in the moment while the guy was there with her, satisfying his body, she was urging and crying out to God to let go of that kind of life, to live a new life. And God, in His compassion, infinite compassion and mercy, heard her prayer right then. And she, after, found out the truth, surrendered to the truth, and today she has a family and is honored and happy. So, my dear listener, so this love of God is not a feeling, but it's an action. It is an action. And it comes to meet those who are calling for Him. And you don't have to make an appointment to come to God's presence. All you need to do is cry out, is to ask. So take part of this campaign we are going to have, that we are going to do, so that you can see how your life is going to change.
I'm caught up in your presence. I just want to sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never want to leave. Oh, I'm not here for blessings. Jesus, you don't owe me anything. More than anything that you can do, I just want you. I'm sorry when I've just gone through the motions. I'm sorry when I just sang another song. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. I'm sorry when I've come with my agenda. I'm sorry when I forgot that you're enough. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. I'm caught up in your presence. I just wanna sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this hole. I never want to leave. Oh, I'm not here for blessings. Jesus, you don't owe me anything. And more than anything that you can do, I just want. I just want you and nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you and nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else. nothing else will do. I just want